Today we will learn about how to fit an isotherm to the data you collected. To begin with, what is an isotherm? Yeah, isotherm is a graph of water activity. The water activity is in this nothing but the equilibrium relative humidity by 100 and the equilibrium moisture content. Typically, it is expressed in dry basis. Before we get further, let's define what is the equilibrium relative humidity and the equilibrium moisture content. So let's say you have a chamber, and let's say you have a biological material or a food product, okay? And the air has a relative humidity, and that is a measure of a moisture content in the air. It is not exactly, it's not defined as a moisture content, but it is a measure of a moisture content. The food product or the biological material has a moisture content too. When you leave it in there, there may be an exchange of moisture between the product and the air. So if it is a very dry product, if the atmosphere is humid, it's going to absorb moisture. If it is a very dry environment and it's a moist product, let's say like a cheese, it's going to lose moisture. And it keeps exchanging until it reaches an equilibrium and there is no exchange of moisture. In that condition, that relative humidity is known as ERH, equilibrium relative humidity. The moisture content is known as equilibrium moisture content. There exists a relationship between equilibrium relative humidity and the equilibrium moisture content. Typically, it is a sigmoidal curve, and it's a property of a material. And it's called as an isotherm because it is at a constant temperature. So when you change the temperature, the curve might shift up or down. That's why it's called as an isotherm. So in the lab, the way you did it was we had environmental chambers, right? So one of them, let's say you had an oven, right? Which is almost a 0% RH, no relative humidity at all. The humidity is zero. It's pretty dry. Let's say you put in a sample which weighs 9.5 grams. So that's the total mass, 9.5 grams. And you leave it for, let's say, a day, and then you weigh it back, and then let's say you have only 4 grams, okay? And the assumption is that, like, there is no bound moisture, so the moisture content is zero. Therefore, the total mass, that means the water is zero, that means the total mass equal to dry mass, which is 4 grams, right? So, as you remember, the dry mass remains the constant, so the dry mass is 4 grams here too. Therefore, the amount of water is equal to 9.5 minus 4 is equal to 5.5 grams. And you can determine the moisture content. M is equal to, in wet basis, 5.5 divided by the total mass, which is equal to 0.5789 or 57.89%. You also take a small sample of that and put it on an environmental chamber containing salt solution. Let's say it maintains 25% relative humidity. And you want to put some mass, but let's say it happened to be a 10.5 grams you put in. In the salt solution, you may want to leave it for 3 to 5 days so that it reaches equilibrium. And let's say your final mass is 6 grams. Okay. The objective is to determine the moisture content of the final product that came out. How do we do that? First of all, you can assume that the moisture content of the sample is the same as that one you put it in the oven, because you split the sample and put one in the oven, put different ones in the different environmental chambers that maintain this constant relative humidity. So you can assume the moisture content to be the same. So the water is equal to the moisture content times the total mass, which is equal to 6.08 gram. The dry mass is total mass minus the water, which should be equal to 4.42 grams. The dry mass remains the constant, so it is again 4.42 grams. So the amount of water present equal to the total mass minus the dry mass, which is equal to 1.578 grams. The mass, the moisture content in dry basis, the capital M, is equal to water divided by the dry mass, equal to 1.578 divided by 4.42, which is equal to 0.357 or 35.7%. So what you would have is an Excel table where you have the equilibrium moisture content, and that is going to be, let's say, 0 is the oven, 25, 33, 55, 75, and 100 is the distilled water. The water activity is nothing but it's in the decimal form, 0.25, 0.33, 0.55, 0.751. And then you go through the calculation which I just demonstrated, you are going to estimate M, which is in dry basis. You are going to have, so the moisture content in the oven that comes out of the oven, it's a 0% moisture content, right? And then the moisture content that comes out of the dry basis, this is 0.357, and then this one you got to calculate, put the values in. Your objective is to fit the data, the Oswin model. The Oswin model states the moisture content in dry basis equal to A into water activity divided by 1 minus water activity whole power n. So your objective is to determine M and N. So how do we do that? So this is a non-linear model. You cannot fit it in Excel directly. You need to make it linear. How can I make it linear? Take a log on both sides. Log of M is equal to, pay attention, the N power is only for water activity by 1 minus water activity. So it's going to be log of A plus N times log of water activity by 1 minus water activity. This is X. This is Y. This is an intercept C. This is the slope M. So what you need to do is you need to calculate log of water activity by 1 minus water activity. And then you need to calculate log of M, right? And then what you need is you need to plot X versus Y. The X is going to be log of water activity divided by 1 minus water activity. The Y is log of M, and you are going to plot those points and fit a linear trend line, and that's going to give an answer Y equal to MX plus C. By comparing these equation, M is equal to N, and C is equal to log of A, therefore A is equal to 10 power C. So that's how you would fit the Oswin model to the data you collected. Let's again review what we did. So you want to fit an isotherm for a sample. You make 6 or 7 samples, approximately the same weight. You put one in the oven to determine the initial moisture content, and you put one in each of the environmental chamber, and you determine what the final moisture content is. And to fit an Oswin model, we linearize the equation. We plotted between these two variables. and use those to determine M and N. That concludes this talk.